TheSenjuGkage back at it again, bring you my Naruto Manga Chapter 686 review. Renegon.
Really?
Now, I did like how Kakashi and Obito went forth with the expectation of sacrificing themselves for Naruto and Sasuke. But to have Ren appear right there at that moment, as if she's willing them to put themselves in front of Naruto and Sasuke, I just found that just a little bit cheesy. But then again, it is Naruto. The whole manga has basically been about everything's going to be okay, everything's going to work out, as long as I have my friends and work hard. Now, I did like that the Sage of Six Paths has a technique that he needs to prepare, or he is preparing, along with the aid of the four Hokage, and requiring the chakra that he gave away to Naruto and Sasuke in order to execute. Now think about this, the Sage of Six Paths said himself that it requires a huge amount of chakra. Now the Sage of Six Paths is already basically a god ninja, right, compared to everybody else. So he already has chakra on a whole other level compared to everybody else. So if he says that it requires a huge amount of chakra, you're talking about some crazy, insane, unfathomable amounts of chakra. That means this technique has got to be the most epic technique seen in the history of Naruto. I also liked how, even though I do get tired of the antagonist in Naruto starting out good and becoming evil and turning back good, Obito's way of going out is respectable. I mean, he sacrificed himself to save the world, to help Naruto and Sasuke save the world. Then he saved Kakashi once again, like he did back at Kanabi Bridge. So it's respectable. If not, a tad bit boring, man. It's boring. I'm tired of antagonists being good, going evil, then being good again and sacrificing themselves for the protagonist. Stop it. Like Kaguya better not get a talking no jutsu and release everyone from the infinite Tsukuyomi. Like that better not be what happened. That cannot be how Kaguya is defeated. Kaguya, Naruto better spirit bomb that bitch. He better throw a spirit bomb or something. I don't know. Now, I'm pretty sure that Kaguya is going to, at some point, when she decides to say more than two sentences in a chapter, she's going to explain history from her perspective, get her backstory. We'll probably see the Sage of Six Paths and his brother and how they looked as a child, how they grew up, etc., etc. And so Musashi might give his audience some way to identify or relate to Kaguya, or to at least feel some type of empathy for Kaguya. But even so, Naruto, you need to destroy Kaguya. You need to erase her existence. None of this talk crap, none of this, that's my ninja way, none of that. This is the end. Which is why, at the same time, I'm glad it's not just Naruto fighting this particular antagonist that is Kaguya. I'm glad we got Sasuke. Because even though Sasuke is crazy, he still is no nonsense. So he's not about that talking and all that crap. No, he's about kill this mofo. Kill this mofo ASAP so I can do what I need to do so the world doesn't end. All in all, this chapter was a tad bit cheesy with Ren appearing yet again. A tad bit cheesy with Obito being another antagonist that starts out good, turns evil, then goes back good, then sacrifices himself for the protagonist. But it was tight in the way that Naruto evaded Kaguya with that shadow clone that had the good Odama. It was tight anticipating the huge technique, the epic technique that the Sage of Six Paths will reveal later on. And that's really the only thing that I was tight about. Everything else was like, oh, not again. Not again. Not another talking on jutsu incoming. Please. Just please, no. I don't want to see Kaguya shedding more tears and then Naruto feeling sorry for her. And then Naruto convincing her to come to the good side or something. Stop. Stop it. Stop it, Musashi. So what did you think of the chapter? Leave your thoughts in the comments below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and share for more Naruto Manga reviews. Until next week, TheSenjuGkage, baby. And that's how we do it.